Hello friends, my name is B.K. Kolhapure. Now we will continue with the chapter on center of gravity or centroid. We had seen in earlier video the centroid of some of the figures. For example, if I take a rectangle, the centroid is at the diagonal bisector at the center. If you take a circle, the centroid of the circle is at the center. If you take a triangle, it is at a distance of 1/3 from the base, h by 3, and this distance will be 2/3 of h. We have seen in case of semicircle, the distance of the centroid of the semicircle from the diameter is 0.424 r. Likewise, we have seen the quarter circle, the centroid of the quarter circle from both the ends, it is 0.424 r. You will have to remember this distance of the centroids. So using these relations, we will try to solve the problems on different combinations using different figures and locate the centroid of the given figure. For example, if I take up an I section of the beam, if this is the I section of a beam, if this width is 80 mm, if the thickness of the flange, this is flange, this is web, and this is again flange, if this is 10 mm, this is the web, let the width of the web be 15 mm and let height of the web be 40 mm, and again the thickness of the web flange at the bottom, let it be 24 mm. So here we are required to find out the centroid of this I section. Now the first step, whenever you want to locate the centroid, you need some axis. So here we will be using the reference axis to locate the centroid. So I will consider the bottommost point, this has 1 1, it is the reference axis in the horizontal direction. Second, I will consider the vertical axis on the leftmost point. So if you see to this and this width, this is the leftmost point, so I will draw an axis here, let this axis be 2 2. So let 1 1 and 2 2 be the reference axis. The reason why we take the lowermost and leftmost is the whole figure will be in the first quadrant. So in first quadrant, x and y will be positive, it will be convenient for us. So here, this is the first step, consider the reference axis. Second step is, we should divide this figure into regular figures. You see here, this is one rectangle, let me call it as G1. This is another rectangle, let the centroid of the rectangle be here G2, and this is a third rectangle, let the centroid of the rectangle be G3. Now in this case, if I cut the figure vertically, the axis is passing through G1, G2 and G3, means this is vertically symmetrical about y-axis. That means when we divide this figure, if I want to know the distance of x from the reference axis, this distance remains the constant from here to here. So in such case, we can directly find out the value of x bar because it is symmetrical about y axis. So this width is total is 80, half of that will be 80 by 2. So this will be 40 mm. So you get directly one of the coordinates if it is symmetrical. Now to locate y bar, we'll have to break it into different components. For that, we'll draw a table here. So component, then area, then distance of centroid from 1 1. So when we measure from 1 1, the distance is ymm. If I call A as the area, then we take moment of area. Moment of area. A into y, it will be the moment of area. And if I draw this line, this is mm cube. So let us begin with the first component. I'll go with g1. g1 is a rectangle. What is the size of this rectangle? This bottom size, if I take it as 25 mm, so size will be 25 by 24. So 25 by 24, this is the area. If you multiply this, you get 600. Now we know the distance of the center of a rectangle is at the center. This is total 24, half will be 12. I need the distance of the center from 1, 1. I need this distance. So this distance will be equal to 24 by 2. So this will be equal to 12. You know A, you know Y. If you multiply them, you get 7200. Likewise, we'll go with G2. G2 is this one. That is also a rectangle. Size of the rectangle is 15 mm by 40 mm. Size 15 by 40. So if you multiply this, you get the value as 600. 60. Now we need the distance of the centroid of the component from 1, 1. I need this distance. One thing is sure, if this is 40, it will be 20 and 20. So you know this distance is 20, but I want from 1, 1. So the distance will be 24 plus 20. So the distance will be equal to 24 plus 40 by 2. So this will be equal to 44 mm. You know A, you know Y. If you multiply them, you get this as 26,400. Then we'll go for the third, G3, this component. This component is also a rectangle. The size of the rectangle is 80 by 10. 80 by 10. So this will be equal to 800. Now, this is the centroid of the component. This being a rectangle, 10 mm is the thickness. So here, this will be 5 mm and 5 mm. I want the distance of the centroid of the figure from 1, 1. So what will be the distance? 24 plus 40 plus 10 by 2. That is 5. So let me write 24 plus 40 plus 10 by 2 is 5. So if you add this, you get the value as 69. You know AY, if you multiply, you get 55,200. There is no more component, so let us draw a line here. We know the distance Y bar is given by sigma AY by sigma A. Now what are the things I need is sigma AY, means I'll have to add all this, and sigma A is I'll have to add all this. If I add all these components, we get sigma A is equal to 20,000. And if I add all these components, sigma AY, so this will be equal to 88800. So now I can use this relation, Y bar is equal to sigma AY by sigma A. So sigma AY is 88800 divided by the total area is 2000. If you simplify this, you get the value of Y bar is equal to 44.4 mm. Now you know the distance of the centroid of this I section. We usually write it as X bar and Y bar. X bar is 40 mm. And Y bar is 44.4 mm. These are the distance of the centroid of the I section from the reference axis 1, 1 and 2, 2. So here the figure is symmetrical, so we get directly X. If it is not symmetrical, then we will have to draw in form of the table and solve the problem. Let us see another problem. let us take another section here. This is a C section. You are required to locate the center of the C section here. So this dimension is 60 mm. Let this thickness be 12 mm. This overall depth from here to here, this which is 150 mm, and this thickness is 10 mm. This width, if I take it as 75 mm, and this thickness, let us take it as 10 mm. Now the first step what we'll have to do is we'll have to consider the reference axis. So our reference axis will be at the bottommost point, let it be 1 1, and on the leftmost point. So this happens to be the leftmost point, so let us call it as 2 2. So 1 1 and 2 2 are the reference axis. Then we will break the given figure into regular figures. Suppose if you see here, I can cut this into a rectangle. This will be G1. I can cut this into another rectangle, this rectangle. This let it be G2. And this will be the third rectangle, G3. This is one option what I can do. There may be number of options, which is the best you can choose. You can divide it like this also. This is one rectangle, this is another rectangle, and this is a third rectangle. Choice is there, you can break it into any form. Let us continue with this. Now the figure is unsymmetrical about both x axis and y axis. So here you will have to find out both x bar, which is given by sigma a y by sigma a, and y bar, which is given by sigma a x by a sigma a y by sigma a. So you have to draw the table for both x and y. So let us divide it, then we'll go to the table. Component, distance, area, a mm square. Then next, distance of centroid from 1 1, that is y mm. Next, distance of centroid from 2 2. So whenever we measure from 2 2, the distance will be x. So you know a, you know y, you know x, so you can find out a y and you can find out a x. So this is our table containing 6 columns. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 columns are required here. So let us begin with G1. This is G1. It is a rectangle. Size of the rectangle is 75 mm by 10 mm. So this will be equal to 750 mm. Then we know the distance of the centroid of the rectangle is at the center. The total depth is 10. So this will be 5 and 5. We need the distance of the centroid from 1 1. So this will be 10 by 2. That is equal to 5. If I multiply these two values, we'll go for x. Now here, I want the distance of the centroid from 2 2. This happens to be the x value. This is y value and this is x value. Total width is 75 mm. Half of that will be the distance of centroid, 75 by 2. So this will be equal to 37.5. So if you multiply a and y, you get ay. So here ay will be 3750. You know a, you know x. If you multiply these two, you get ax is equal to 28125. Likewise, we'll go to g2. This is the component g2. It's again a rectangle. Size of the rectangle is 10 mm by this distance. Now the total height is given to you is 150. So we need the distance from here to here. So this distance from here to here, if you find out, it will be 128 mm. 150 minus 12 minus 10. So this will be 128 mm. So using this relation, 10 mm by 128 is equal to 1280. Now we know the distance of the centroid is at the center. So total distance is 128. So half of that. But I want from 1, 1. So the distance from 1, 1 will be 128 by 2 plus this 10 mm, or 10 plus 128 by 2. So I'll write in 10 plus 128 by 2. So you get this distance is equal to 74 mm. Now this is 2, 2. I want the distance of centroid from 2, 2, this distance. Total thickness, you know, is 10. So this will be equal to 5. Distance from 2, 2. So this will be equal to 10 by 2 is equal to 5. You know A and Y. If you multiply A and Y, you get 94720. And if you multiply A and X, you get AX is equal to 6400. Now coming to G3, this component. G3 is also a rectangle. Size of the rectangle is 60 mm by 12 mm. 60 by 12. So if you multiply this, you get 720. Now, this is a centroid. This is 12 mm. It will be at the center. So 12 by 2 will be 6. But I want the distance from 1, 1. So go on adding the height. So this is from here to here, 10 plus 128 plus 6 mm. You get the height. Or another option is go up to the top, 150, then minus 5. Any option you can do. So this is better, go up to the top, 150 minus 6 mm. Or you can go like this also, 10 plus 128 plus half of 6. So this will be 12 by 2. So this will be equal to 144 mm. Now we need the distance of the centroid of the component from 2, 2. I need this distance. Total width is 60. Half of that will be 30. So this will be 60 by 2 is equal to 30. So if you multiply A and Y, you get 103680. And if you multiply A and X, you get 21600. Now we have taken all the components. Let us find out. We need sigma A. We need sigma AY. We need sigma AX. We'll add all this. So you get sigma A is equal to 2750. Sigma AY, you get 202150. And you get this as 56125. So x bar is given by sigma ax by sigma a. So this will be equal to sigma ax. Carefully you take the column 56125 divided by total area is 2750. So if you simplify this, you get x bar is equal to 20.41 mm, and similarly y bar is equal to sigma ay by sigma a. So this will be equal to sigma ay is 202150 divided by total area is same 2750. If you simplify this, you get y bar is equal to 73.51 mm. So the corners of the centroid of this I section are, so 20.44 mm and 73.51 mm. So this is how you have to locate the centroid of the given figures. Here we have seen almost all the figures are rectangular in section. Simple, if you are able to locate area, distance x and distance y of the different component, you can take up any type of problem. So this is today's video. So please subscribe to the channel for more videos. Press the bell icon to get the notifications and go to the comment section and you can ask your questions. Thank you very much.